I'm figuring you're just going to use whatever you want from this, and there are no boundaries. Hi, I'm Trish Sie, and I'm the director of The Sleepover, and this is my mood board. The most inspiring thing visually for this movie was actually just being in Boston. It's a city with so much character, so much personality, so much history. The greenery there, it's different than the green where I live. And all the brick and all of the stone and all of the architecture and the textures, everything just kind of has a very specific look in Boston. That just really had a big impact on the color palettes that we chose, the textures, even the angles and stuff that we chose to use. The Athenaeum, which is the library that we shoot in, and the Wang Center where we shot the interior of the gala, even the Finch House. There's an abundance of riches when it comes to beautiful cinematic locations. It felt really important that we treat this movie like an adventure movie, period, and we not treat it differently because it was geared toward families and children. So I really watched a lot of just adventure stories, action stories, comedies. I love Edgar Wright. I think Hot Fuzz is one of like the most perfect movies ever made. I also like Scott Pilgrim. Edgar Wright is a huge influence in general. I just watch a lot of these kind of quirkier action movies that are sort of character driven because I really don't want it to feel like we're pandering to kids and families. I want it to feel like a legitimate adventure, and it doesn't really matter whether it's PG or not. There's a New Zealand photographer named Julia Krim, and I came across this beautiful photograph of these four kids running through starlight, essentially. It's like they're in silhouette, it's so beautiful. And it just sort of served as a touchstone in a way. Whenever I would kind of have a question, I would go back to that image and just look at it and be like, does what I'm thinking live in the world that this image represents? And if it didn't, it's out the door. But one thing I do while I'm working on a movie is I read a lot. And one of the books I was reading while we were making this movie was Zadie Smith's book, Feel Free. I loved the spirit of it. And every time, kind of like that photograph, I kind of had a question about what direction to go in, I would just like flip through my Zadie Smith book, and she kind of always has the answer for you. I think one of the things that really appealed to our costume designer, Deborah McGuire, is just all the opportunities in this story for cool, weird clothing choices. You know, the souvenir shop t-shirts and the colonial costume display, and of course the gala with all of the beautiful dresses. I really wanted to capture that feeling that I got back in the 80s when I was watching all my favorite movies. Goonies, Stand By Me, The Princess Bride, E.T., Adventures in Babysitting. You know, these films, they had these fabulous ensembles that just worked together so well, and each character was memorable but fit like a piece in a puzzle into sort of a larger group. And I just have such nostalgia for those movies. I just wanted to create something that felt like that. I see a vision so beautiful. With everybody running around on set doing separate jobs, music is such a unifying force. In the morning when we'd be setting up for the day, I would just play music. We would go from, you know, Maria Muldaur to Sophie Tucker to Chaka Khan to Prince. It gets everybody kind of moving in the morning, but it also kind of subliminally puts us all in the same state of mind, moving together at the same rhythm. It was a fun way to put us sort of all on the same page, create a tone on set that we were all a part of. This is a movie that is geared toward young people. It is supposed to have this kind of like whirling dervish of energy throughout it. So we used a lot of jump cuts, we used some montages, we used a lot of like very snappy edits. I wanted it to just be so crisp, so clean, and so just kind of unapologetic about the way it went from one thing to the next. Another thing I did to get ready for this movie was look at a lot of kids performing. Because of course, Clancy performs, and Kevin with his bathroom dance performs. Even Lewis, when he like has to jump to try and get through the window.
Well, you can give me a hand with this part.
Oh, right.
Yeah,
right.
Okay.
We're just watching.
Sorry.
I'm sort of fascinated by kids that are able to just get out there and do their thing in front of people. There were two kids in particular. There's a boy named Zhang Fei. I've never seen anything like it. I'm not gonna say very much about it because it's better if you just watch it. He's amazing. And then there was also this girl, Sujari Britt, who's a cellist. The boy dancing and the girl playing cello, like watching them just fearlessly put their stuff out there for people to watch, it was really inspiring. We all know what stories can do, and whether we come from dance, we come from writing, we come from parenting, we come from teaching. So once you realize that life is all just kind of watching people's stories unfold, filmmaking just seems like a really unique window to looking at it and sharing it with other people. That was my mood board. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And now go watch The Sleepover on Netflix.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.